I'm here with Jermaine Soto, known as JJ. He's a K-1 fighter, and this weekend at the LA Sports Arena, he's going to enter the ring for a big fight. Check it out. 3, 2, 1. So JJ, we're here, K-1, you're fighting this weekend, LA Sports Arena. What's it like for you to be on this big stage?
It's a huge honor for me. I've fought in front of several crowds before, but nothing like K-1. This is the biggest fight organization in the world. I mean, you can't get no better than this. This is a huge honor for me. I'm super excited. I just can't wait till Saturday.
Last time I saw you, you fought in Woodland Hills. You dominated. You knocked the guy down. You knocked him out. What can we expect from this fight?
This fight, hopefully, you'll see a much more faster, much stronger, better Jermaine. This time, I had plenty of time to train for the fight. Everything's just going really well according to schedule. Actually, we were ahead of schedule with our training, so we wanted to tone it down, but I said, you know, let's just go ahead and keep it going. Thanks to everybody, my team, Edmund, Edgar, my strength and conditioning coach, they helped get me ready for this, and I'm just excited. I'm actually more excited, I think, than I've ever been for a fight. I wish I could actually watch my fight.
Well, if they tape it for you, you'll be able to.
But it's nothing like seeing the real thing.
But on a big stage in L.A. where thousands of people are hand. And what would you tell people about K-1 in general? What does it mean to be a K-1 fighter?
Well, being a K-1 fighter is, it's more than just being a fighter. This is about being legendary. This is a huge organization, like I said before, and they pick the best of the best. And just to be part of this is just a huge honor for me and anybody else that fights this organization. I mean, it's just a whole surreal experience for me.
How did you end up being a kickboxer, Muay Thai fighter out of every sport on the planet?
Well, initially, I started with Taekwondo. I moved on to karate, hapkido, kickboxing, Muay Thai, and now I'm back. So, I mean, I'm a stand-up fighter, and that's pretty much where my base is and where I want to be. And K-1, like I said, is the best of the best. And to really test my skills after 21 years of training, there's no other place I'd rather be.
How many black belts do you have?
I have a black belt in Taekwondo, another black belt in American Taekwondo, black belt in Hapkido, black belt in Karate. So I have 4 black belts.
But you're very humble. You're not flossing. I would have walked around with all 4 of them. Like, hey, I have 4 different black belts. I can kick your ass in 20 different ways.
Yeah, well, it's more than just being a black belt. It's about being a martial artist. You know, it doesn't really matter what kind of belt you have. You know, so long as you're humble and show respect to the art, some people that have black belts don't even deserve it.
What, so, politics, marketing, they just give them out?
A lot of them, it's like, you know, it's easy to get a black belt so long as you train and, you know, pay your dues.
But you didn't have it easy, did you?
No, I didn't have it easy. I started off at a really young age. I started competing at 13. So I fought competitively from 13 up until now. I'm doing it for a living. So I'm, like I said, 21 years of training. It's just, you know, it's almost like a never-ending battle as a martial artist. You just continuously grow, you continuously learn, and you always try to stay humble.
Is there one martial art that's better than another? Because I talk to Hapkido people, and they say, we're the best. You talk to Jeet Kune Do, we're the best. You talk to, let's say, Krav Maga, forget everything else. You want to survive, stick with us.
Yeah.
Which is it?
You know what? There really isn't one martial arts that's better than the next. Every martial arts has their, you know, their pros and their cons. I really can't speak negative towards any martial arts because I feel like each one has something to offer. And, you know, depending on your body type, some people might be great in karate and some people might be better in judo. You know, it's all up to the person. So, I mean, some people just don't have the flexibility or the strength or even the mindset to continuously be in one particular martial art. So I cannot say that there's one better than the next because they're all great.
If you had to name for me the 3 greatest martial artists ever, who would they be?
Oh, wow.
Bruce Lee, number one.
You know what? It's hard to say. I couldn't name 3 because there's a lot of, nowadays everybody studies martial arts, so you really can't say that there's just 3 martial artists that are the best. But I mean, people I look up to would definitely be like a Bruce Lee, Chuck Norris, Van Damme, even guys like Steven Seagal.
I haven't heard Chuck Norris in a while, man.
Yeah, Chuck Norris is amazing. And he's still kicking, and he's an amazing martial artist. But like I said, these are some of the people that I look up to because of their accomplishments, but there's plenty of other martial artists out there that we've never seen, never heard of, that, you know, in their own world, that they're the best, you know, and I plan on being on top of that list.
Well, keep doing what you're doing. You're doing a great job. Now, have you seen the Shaolin documentaries about the monks in the Shaolin?
I have, as a matter of fact.
Are those real or is that fake?
You know what? I believe that it's mind over matter. So you can push your body to all kind of limitations. So I really can't speak on that, but I did go check out the Shaolin Will of Life tour and was very impressed.
Why?
Oh, man. They have 4-year-old kids that were standing on one leg doing the splits for like 5 minutes, front flips on their head with no hands, just... I would give myself a concussion trying to do something like that.
There you have it. Stay tuned for more. Make sure to look out for JJ this weekend, LA Sports Arena. He's fighting with K1. Stay tuned for ESNEWS.com. I'm Elisek back reporting. Take a step back.